right. Here we go.
Yo.
Yo. Episode 21.
Is this episode 21? I thought this was episode 20.
No, that was last week.
Shit. Bad news.
This is our last podcast episode ever.
Ever, yeah. We decided to quit because we've already reached the top.
Yeah. Let's finish while we're on top. We don't have that downfall.
No.
We don't want to be on those, like, Watch Mojo videos of top 10 podcasts you fell off.
Mm-hmm. We're retiring with the belt, so they say. Yeah, speaking of, this is the first time they've seen me alive, isn't it? Since the fight, you know?
Oh, yeah, yeah. That was it feels like ages ago.
The fight?
Yeah.
Yeah, it does. But I'm fucking hell, I'm still feeling it.
Yeah, I'm going traveling next week, so it's going to be like 3 weeks. Fortunately,
3 weeks of
bliss. Not that anyone's asked, but 3 weeks of no podcast. But yeah.
What's that one guy that always comments? Isn't him at Callum Green?
Yeah, Callum. Shout out Callum.
Beast
Callum.
Bro? Yeah, I saw I hope he doesn't get laid out. I didn't get laid out.
So speaking of, we're gonna
watch
get,
the fight.
We're just gonna get straight into it.
Where's the
remote? So it's just gonna be on screen as we're watching it.
Yeah, it's over here for us though.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah.
Fuck you guys.
What's your initial before we go in?
Yeah, I've obviously
comments on the fight on.
It was mad
no spoilers.
How much I forgot. I'll say that when I rewatched it, I was like, damn. Mm. I also, rewatching it, I feel like I look so amateur. Like, so... I feel so sloppy, and I'm like, why did I do that? Why did I do that? God, you look like a dickhead. Put your fucking chin down. Like...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, it's your first fight, isn't it? Like,
sure.
You know, you're not going to be Roy Jones or John Jones.
No,
when are you? Right, here we go. Loads.
Mm-hmm.
Here we go.
Yeah. This announcer guy bought Will a monster.
Yeah, yeah, I was there, yeah.
God, what a shit walkout song. I'd never walk out to this. People who walk out to this song are a puss.
Might be
getting Archie on the
might
podcast.
Might be getting Archie on the podcast. That'd be pretty sick.
1,000 likes on the podcast. Nah, Archie's a cool dude.
I hope we don't get copyrighted for putting songs on.
Oh, yeah. We actually might.
Well, to be fair, if they've uploaded on YouTube, they haven't been copyrighted, have they? Yet.
Yeah, touch wood.
Should report them. Flag the video. Flag all the videos for copyright except ours, so everyone can only watch our video.
Oh, also, straight off the bat, he got Vaseline, I didn't. I forgot about that.
Really?
Yeah, so that was just probably, you know. Nah, I don't think it makes that much of a difference, does it?
I don't know. Maybe like a slightly different, maybe like to not get caught a little bit.
Yeah.
Like help protect cuts. Especially if you've got like quite thin skin prone to getting cut, then it probably will help a lot.
I think it is funny the general difference in walkouts.
Mm.
Like,
in what way?
It's like, you know, there's this coach like trying to like hype him up, it feels like.
Yeah.
Nerves at an all-time high.
Yeah, were you feeling nervous?
Was I feeling nervous? No.
Really?
In the changing room, when it was time to walk in, I was like, okay, here we go. This is real now. And then as soon as I got to that corridor and I heard my music playing, I was like, yeah, easy. This is it.
I couldn't understand anything what he was saying with the mic. No offense to the guy, but the mic, the quality of the mic was terrible. It just sounded like...
Oh, what a pimp. This is pimp music to walk out to.
You were loving the walkout, to be fair.
Yeah, bro, because that's how I was saying.
there's your brother.
Yeah. Confidence here is at an all-time high.
I want to know where the party's at. Can I bring my gap? Hope I don't get shot.
What a beast. The ring girl in the back rapping to it as well. Yeah, there you go.
You can see us there.
Boys, yeah. At this point, I remember it was so fucking smoky in the octagon.
Yeah.
And like, I couldn't see his face, obviously, because I didn't have my glasses on. No. So I just sort of knew. I just stared at the area where his head was.
Did you feel like that sort of affected you not having your glasses?
No, because when you're fighting, you're up here. I can see. I can see you when you're here.
Okay. You know, we got asked to move.
Yeah, which is weird.
Yeah, but then they didn't ask anyone else to move.
No.
Bias.
Boom. Takes a little jab, first blood.
Yeah.
And bam.
Ooh, nice leg kick.
Very telegraphed. He does a big step.
Mm.
And it took me a second to catch on to it. Brawl in. Nice little front kick. Oh.
Ooh.
Is it now? Yeah, boom.
Wee.
I was so like so annoyed about this because
you got tied up.
He traversed me, and I'm so bad off the cage. I've got like little experience with it. I remember like I was trying to get underhooks, and then that was like, oh okay. I remember that sort of hurting, but there's one that properly knocked the wind out of me. Where is it?
Can you shoulder barge in amateur MMA?
I don't know. That one. That
one. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And, hang on. Wait for it. Because, yeah, the underhooks are there and I'm just not going for them. This bit, instead of trying to do, like, I do the trip and I fuck it, I should have just took the whizzer out and backed off.
Mm-hmm.
But he just pushed me straight back. And then, yeah.
Did he catch you with that?
No, I don't think so. He might have, but I don't really remember. Don't know what I was doing there. Yeah. I don't remember doing that. Like, it's so crazy how much of this I've forgotten.
It's just in the moment, isn't it? You're not thinking about...
Yeah.
Like, there's no thought processes. You're mainly on instinct.
Mm-hmm.
I remember screaming, just, fire the jab,
I remember. I can't remember anything Danny said to me in this, apart from one bit in the third round where he's screaming, pressure, pressure, pressure.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But I remember hearing you.
It would be funny to watch back. I haven't, like, probably watched back my recording.
Be a shaky ass.
You're literally probably going to hear me screaming.
Yeah.
Nice. Gotta keep that right hand up though. You almost got your check up there.
Yeah, that's a big thing, is me dropping my hands. And here, my chin. I feel, when I'm doing that, I feel like my chin is tucked away, but here it looks so open.
Yeah.
And especially when I, like,
when you throw as well.
Yeah, look, see, I started to get onto it then. Checked it.
Nice.
It looks, pisses me off. Because it just looks so, like, weak. And yeah, it caught me nice there. Check that. Yeah, he just said, like, thanks.
The music was decent, to be fair. I was enjoying it, you know.
Yeah.
You see Miles? Mm-hmm. Miles and me? Yeah, that was, this is when we got moved. You can see us moving out the way.
Heavy. Danny was just saying to me, like, he said that I looked really good. Keep my distance, chin down, get in and out. Yeah, I think that's what he was saying.
Boop, boop. Usher. What do you reckon his corner was saying?
This guy looks unbeatable. Just try not to lose.
Yeah.
Yeah, he got way more fucking camera time than me. Yeah. What the fuck is this?
You were the home fighter as well.
Yeah, I know, right?
Surely you should be getting all the bias.
Mm-hmm. Well, his coach was saying that. His coach posted on Instagram after the fight that he thought Archie won all three rounds, and the only reason the result was what it was because of the home.
Ooh. Thing. I suppose you've got to back your boy at the end of the day, haven't you?
You have to, but like...
You've got to be humble.
Yeah. See, I don't like this round, so I'm going to pretend it didn't exist. Yeah, hit me in the dick then. Firmed it though.
Nice job.
Thanks. I'm off balance. I'm just trying to, in those bits, I'm just trying to fight. And that's what fucks me. Yeah,
turn
what the
back.
Fuck was that?
Turn your back.
I knew I had to turn because of the momentum of the kick. Mm-hmm. But like, if I'm going to throw that spinning kick, I should have just committed to it. But I just did a little half thing. It's because I don't like throwing it fully in training.
Mm-hmm.
And they're right. What you do in training, you know. Had him in a
flat how you train.
Guillotine for a second, just pulled out. Was not strong, and then because I'm okay on my back, but I don't know what I was doing here. Like, should be trying to turn my hips, you know, outwards and then push out. I'm just doing nothing. I'm trying to wrap his feet so I can try and bridge. Didn't work. Controlling his arm. I had good wrist control. I thought that was good. Was stopping that, you know, the punches. Yeah, just trying to shrimp out. And then I think, right, let him into side control so that I could try and buggy choke him. And when is it? There, yeah. I get it for like a second. And then he pulls his head out. Like, fuck. But as he tries to get him out, boom! Look
nice.
At that.
Nice.
I was tired. Like, I was just sort of like, right, semi. I should have been trying to knee side. Yeah, I was holding the fence then. I felt like it was just a reaction.
Yeah.
I should have been trying to knee slice through his guard. Didn't do it. And then as I'm too high. I'm so high on my base then. It's bad. And so he can just do that. Decent reversal from him. Ate a few punches.
Yeah, I remember here being like, fuck.
Yeah, but then, you know, because I'm an animal, get out of it. Don't remember any of this. Remember none of this. Yeah, I've definitely lost this round. This round is not mine. I don't remember how this round end, because I don't remember. I don't think it didn't end on the cage. Yeah. Tired there, fucking hell.
Yeah. You both look tired.
Yeah.
I remember shouting, "Just keep going, he's tired."
Yeah. Yeah, looking his fucking good. But he knows he's won that round. See that little thing he did then? Fuck you.
Another tune. I just seen on Instagram the next show is like 29th October.
Yeah, dancing into the chat. Should be exciting. You gonna try and get on it?
Possibly. Hold so Yeah, they really aren't giving you any screen
time.
No,
yeah, I got no screen time for this corner bit.
Well, it would be sick if they had mics in the corner.
Yeah.
Like, to hear what they were saying.
Mm-hmm. I remember at this point, because I was on Danny's shoulders like that, mm-hmm. and I put my forehead on Danny's forehead because I was tired. I was very tired here. But then when the round started, you know, cheeky little look round. All that fucking last push shit that you do mm-hmm. training.
That's where that pays off.
Yeah.
The championship rounds.
Mm-hmm. There we go. Check. Boom.
Nice front kick.
Ate it. You can feel it. Yeah, his check hook is good. It is. Mm. He said, we were talking about it, he said that he was scared to throw his right hand, and so he had been... Oh, took it like a beast, though.
Yeah. Just unfazed.
Check hook.
Check hook, yeah.
Yeah, check hook was very good. Fighting a bit of southpaw then, looking to go. Yeah, it was so fucking annoying. He kept, like, moving away, and I was just like, right, okay, I'm just going to have to chase you down, but it was fucking annoying.
You weren't cutting it off properly?
No, I didn't cut it off. I followed. Check. Boom. I'm here for this. Is it this bit? No. No, it's after this. Might be now. Yeah, heavy breaths from Archie. Check up again.
You keep that right hand up as you're coming in.
Yeah. Yeah, kick me in the dick there. And then as I looked to the corner, I saw all three, like Danny, Key and Ronan, all stand up and just shout, he's knackered. So I just tapped there, I was like, I'm ready to go.
Nice.
Wait for it. Yeah, Danny screaming pressure. Uppercut, bam. Uppercut,
nice.
Bam. Mouth guard out. Boom, boom.
Should mixed up to the body as well.
Yeah, no, I thought
go,
that. I was
right, uppercut,
head,
left,
I was
left
hook. So bad.
Just straight on.
Yeah. Check.
Nice.
Check hook though. That was the photo where my foot goes off the ground.
Oh. Nice.
The uppercuts were working for me, so yeah. I kept going for them. And like Danny.
It's because he's when he's shelling up,
yeah,
he's got that
down.
And he's got that open in the middle, in the middle of his hands.
What am I doing there? I'm just tired at that point.
Yeah.
I'm just thinking push. Chin in the air though.
Oof. Yeah. You gotta watch out for that checkup.
Yeah, he caught me so many times. See, like after the hit another head kick. Yeah, keys there. Yeah, like after the fight when I was thinking about it, I don't remember eating leg kicks.
Yeah.
But then after watching, I'm like, fuck, I took a few.
Mm-hmm.
Like, he got me good. He was just saying today, like, your cardio's sick. And I was like, oh, good fight, thanks.
Hands raised.
Yeah, I thought I lost. Like, I just put my hands up because that's what people do. But I thought that was a loss for me because of the thing. Oh, and then the medical lady was trying to shine the torch in my eyes, and I just wanted to sit down. I was not in the mood. Yeah, no fucking camera time on me.
No.
Like,
the right camera time. Talk to me, girl.
Sorry, I actually didn't want to be sharing at all. Don't worry.
A draw.
Yeah.
Man.
Anticlimactic.
Yeah.
But yeah, so that was my fight.
Would you rematch?
I see, if I hadn't been speaking to him, like afterwards, yeah. But at the moment, like,
you feel quite sound with him.
Yeah, he's sound to fight again.
Yeah.
I think overall, for a first fight, I think I had the perfect sort of experience. I didn't
think
too much damage. Like, obviously, my leg has been fucked up for a while, but like, aside from that, the weigh-ins were fine. There was respect back there. There was no like beef or anything. On actual fight day, ran into him as well. Nothing there. Like, and then afterwards, we've just been like exchanging photos and just chatting shit, like, you know. I'd say it's a pretty good experience. do you want to do them in for me?
Now, watching, like, when I was there watching it, I was like, yeah, I do want to do this.
Yeah.
It was a good atmosphere as well. Like, it was a good event, like, in general.
Yeah. How many people were there when I walked out? Because I didn't really see. But there was a lot afterwards.
There was quite a bit, to be fair. I think it was after, I think Dan Thorogood's fight, it sort of went down a little bit.
Mm.
And I think then more people started to come in towards, like, when Danny was fighting and who's the guy before him? I can't remember what his name was.
Was it the kickboxing one? No,
it was like a title fight.
It was the one before Danny was Darren Castleton and Dave Jones.
Right, okay.
That guy, his coach. That was another pro MMA. But then before that was Cody White fighting for the title. But then he just fucking leg kicked him and the guy went down. Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah, it was not.
Dude, that's what's so good about like making your own event. Like, do you
think that they cherry picked?
I don't know. Maybe some of the fights.
I don't know.
Some were like definitely fair. But yeah, like the leg kick and then going down. It's kind of like.
Well, fuck, we can watch it if you want. Like, see what you think of it. I'll just skip to the bit. Hang on. No.
Nice. Just search Dragon Fight.
Oh yeah, what the fuck have I searched?
Just on my phone.
No. COD. Whoa, lad. This is. What have I done?
Hang on. Hang on. I've got it here. There you go.
Yeah, about CTE for real. Yeah, just skip. No point watching 6 minutes of them walking out, you know what I mean? Cody's a scary man. I hate sparring Cody.
That guy does not look. Yeah. That guy does not look in shape.
No. See, the thing is, I know a couple of opponents dropped out. I know Danny's opponents dropped out.
Okay.
So they could fully be the replacements.
That's fair.
Yeah, I don't think Danny's wanted to cherry pick.
Yeah.
He's not Khabib. I also think, as well, mentally, going into a pro MMA fight. And standing in the octagon and seeing Danny Dixon, like, he is a big lightweight. He's tall. And
he's taller than you.
No, fuck no. But he's like, he's not far. He's probably six. I reckon he's 6 foot. He's jacked. Like, I would not want to fight Danny Dixon. It was only 40 seconds long. We can watch that one as well.
I'll put that on. Let me find it. The Regan fight was really good. Like, finished him straight away.
Sick. Felt bad for Dan. Felt bad for Dan. Skip.
Yeah.
You see me in this as well at the end.
Woo! I'll skip past that bit as well. Here we go.
Me eating the Dominoes after my fight. Boom. Like, what the fuck is that? Like, I think he tries to kick him in the air.
I think he tried to get away as well, that guy.
And then it's just
domination
from the side. He didn't throw a punch. Like, that guy was scared. And he's got FCC shorts on, which means that he's done it before, at least, or he just robbed them off someone, I guess.
You see Harry in the back there.
Yeah, and then there's me at the back, very back, top left, in the white t-shirt. There I am again. There's Will.
Will, yeah.
Yeah, so. Apparently got Andrew Tate in there as well. What the fuck?
Andrew Tate.
Yeah.
I seen one thing, it was like Jake Paul and Andrew Tate was like rumored to fight each other, or one of them call each other out or something.
I'd love to see that.
That would just be pure entertainment.
That would just be pure entertainment.
Just like for the build up itself, just watching Jake Paul and Andrew Tate go back and forth.
Jake Paul's supposed to be fighting, isn't he?
Yeah, he's fighting Haseem Rahman Jr.
Who's that? Is he a boxer?
His dad knocked out Lennox Lewis.
Oh shit!
Yeah, but like that was like it was a big upset. You know, like the Mike Tyson Buster Douglas thing.
Yeah, yeah.
But then they fought. Lennox and Rackman fought in a rematch, and Lennox just absolutely beasted him and just went on to just dominate the heavyweight division. Yeah. I don't know what his son's like, but I mean it's a step up for him.
Yeah,
genuine boxer. Yeah, yeah. I respect him, to be fair.
Who, Jake Paul, the other guy?
Jake Paul, for like what he's doing. Like, you can hate on him. But at the end of the day, no one's forcing you to watch him. It's not like you're being forced to watch Jake Paul.
Mm.
And two, he's bringing eyes to the sport and he's making absolute bank. Like, you should learn from him. Like, he's hyping people up. Like, he's building up hype and he's making millions off of it.
I don't respect him as a person. Mm-hmm. But, like, I don't necessarily... He's fighting, you know what I mean? It's like, I'm always down to watch a fight, especially if it's someone I don't like.
Yeah. Know? Yeah.
Because it is that chance of, yeah, if he wins, okay, I'm not arsed. But if he gets knocked out, sick.
Yeah. Yes!
Yeah,
you
know what I mean?
You seen KSI's fighting as well?
Oh, yeah, Alex Wasabi.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
I don't think KSI will beat Jake Paul now.
No.
I think Jake Paul's gone too far. The skill gap. Because he's been quite... Like, to be fair, like, he's been dedicated to it. He's been, like, actually properly training.
Yeah.
Like, he's been sparring hard and shit, and, like... He's been consistent with the lifestyle. Like, KSI's been going on... He's still been training, but he's going on, like, music tours and shit and festivals. He's not, like...
Which is still sick, you know?
Yeah. Like, get the bag, enjoy your life, innit? Do what you want.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I don't feel like...
From the fights I've seen him in where he just swings,
Yeah.
Like, Jake Paul's knockout of Tyrone Woodley was, like... What's the word? Logical, the whole sort of faint low, go high, like that is boxing theory. And so, I don't think, it's not hard theory to understand, but KSI's never implemented boxing theory. He just swings.
No, he hasn't. I saw on the news the other day, I listened on the radio. This sort of ties in, you can tie it into like boxing and whatnot.
Okay.
I can't remember the name. But it was horrible what happened. It was some girl last year in Liverpool who got stabbed in Liverpool 1. Mm-hmm. I think it was November time. She was 15.
Fucking hell.
And it was over... I'm just Googling another name. Yeah, here we go. Teenager jailed for murder of stabbed schoolgirl Ava White. Oh no, she was 12. I think the boy was 15. Do you know what it was over?
Go on.
A fucking Snapchat video. In the neck. She got stabbed in the neck.
Did she die?
Yeah, she's dead.
Fucking hell.
And he's been given life.
Good.
But then it said on the news. After like 13 or 15 years, he'll be given a chance to like appeal or whatever. So he could come out when he's 28. But that man should be locked away forever.
Yeah, fucking hell. If you're stabbing a 12-year-old girl.
And they're not releasing his name because of like protection and privacy.
Like John Venables and that shit.
So, honestly, like, it's disgusting. It's honestly, and I wanted to, you know, question it. How can we, look at this knife crime. In America, they got guns. Knife crime, this is like, oh, that's like.
Mm-hmm.
Our thing in the UK.
Yeah.
Like, what can we do? What the fuck?
I always have the same thing with guns. It's like, guns are too easy to get in America, but you're never going to be able to stop people getting them now. It's far too late for that shit.
With knives, it's like, you can only put restrictions on them.
Yeah, because you could just go to Argos.
Yeah.
But also, you can't buy a machete from Argos, you know what I mean?
That's true, but like, even just like a sharp kitchen knife. You still do damage with that, can't you? You still, like, slash someone and shit.
Yeah.
The main thing is just, like, education, innit? Mm. And, like, people need to go... I think people should, like... When you go to a boxing or MMA gym or, like, some form of a combat gym, you're doing some form of combat sport, it's good because it humbles you and you like you get that confidence if you can protect yourself. You don't need to feel like you can hold a knife on the street.
Yeah. Although, one thing, right? Do you know what Aikido is?
Aikido?
Yeah. It's martial
I've heard of it.
I remember Finn wanted to do it, so I like Googled what it is. And it's more of like a choreographed. Yeah, that's what it is. Choreographed like dance,
right?
Like where you're like throwing people around and stuff, and it's like, I guess yeah, you could call it martial art, and it's cool. But they always seem to. I've seen so many Aikido versus MMA because they like they think yeah. they have the same level of protection, mm-hmm. and it's like, don't do Aikido unless you want to do it
like,
for fun,
like a genuine martial yeah. art, you know, like a fighting, like Muay Thai, kickboxing. MMA.
Cross training. Box fit with Andy from Avatar Fitness.
That will get you prepared for the streets.
That, yeah, the streets are a dangerous place, right? And Andy knows yeah. them like the back yeah. of his hand.
Yep. Like jiu-jitsu, yeah. wrestling.
Right. Obviously, if jiu-jitsu is effective in a street fight.
Mm-hmm. To a point, like once you got on the ground, where you can like throw people.
Yeah, see, I always, like...
You're not going to go...
Yeah, you ground, just get stomped you? In the head. Yeah. Like... People who've never done jiu-jitsu are always like, yeah, well, it's not effective in a street fight, like, whatever. But I have, you know. I'm an official undefeated MMA fighter now, who's on topology.com, right? So
0-0-1.
My opinion means quite a lot.
Yeah, yeah.
If you're on the ground, yeah, great. Or if you want to throw them to the ground, yeah, sick. But, like, it's not that great. Maybe it's because I'm not good enough. Maybe when I get like to a black belt, I'll yeah. be like, you know,
yeah, yeah.
crazy at it.
Yeah, I expect you would be through a black belt.
Well, yeah, but as we know, you can get black belts pretty easily around these ends.
Like a proper like jiu-jitsu school, a proper martial arts school.
Yeah.
Not some places. If a good rule of thumb I said to you, if they wear shoes on the mat, mm-hmm. do not trust a word they say if they wear shoes on the mat.
Yeah.
Run. Do not pay him any money. No. Just go. Just turn around. Yeah. Go find somewhere else.
Shoes on the mat, isn't it?
Go and watch. Go watch some YouTube videos, some YouTube tutorials.
Honestly, yeah.
You probably learn. You might learn a bit more. Like instead of.
Yeah, people who wear shoes on the mat want your money, yeah. and people who don't want wear the shoes on the mat understand the sport and they understand like the respect behind it.
Mm-hmm.
It's fucked up. There are a lot of fucking money grabbers out there, man.
I feel like boxing and like any like combat sports, it's sort of good as well, especially for because it's mainly people in like impoverished areas that are committing these sort of crimes, aren't they?
Yeah.
Realistically, really, I feel like a lot of people are frustrated with their like their environment and where they are, and like they feel like they don't have like much opportunities in life.
No,
so I feel like the boxing MMA stuff that like fighting. One gives them an output of their frustration, and two also like teaches them, oh, I'm not like worthless. I have got opportunities. I've got you can dedicate yourself to something and make progress in it, and you can see yourself making progress in it. Cause especially a lot of kids like don't like school. They don't like sitting in the classroom. They want to like they got loads of energy they need to burn off. Just like listen to a teacher waffle on all day is like not good for them.
No.
It's good for like you probably do better in school if you go into like sort of like boxing or MMA because you like it's good for your brain. Well, short term, the exercise, yeah. Long term, it's not good for your brain. depends on how you spar and fight.
Yeah, if your strategy is put your hands down,
defend with your
chin.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, if you've got a chin like mine,
it's still gonna catch up to you.
I give it like 3 years and I'll already be like drooling a bit, you know, when I speak.
Someone to wipe your ass.
Yeah.
if I ever get to that point, like put a bullet in my head or just take me out. I would rather keep my dignity, take my losses and just leave.
Fair.
Rather than just like every day, like painfully wake up.
Yeah.
Some like nurse. It's time to wake up.
Mm-hmm.
Give me some of my sloppy warm food that I just swallow. I don't even like have to mm-hmm. chew. Just
the only thing dribble. You could say. Wait, baby.
That is like your dignity gone though if someone has to wipe your ass.
Well, there are some people who are like disabled and shit, and it's like you can't say that's their dignity gone.
Well,
like,
for me,
that's
my dignity gone. I would, yeah.
Because I feel like if there's, you know, some poor disabled person watching this, and you know they hear you say that, their idol say that.
The idol, like, you know. My God.
Yeah, you are in your Tinder bio. It does say you're a famous podcast host. So,
oh, yeah, we should talk about that. So last night
we tried to make dating profiles.
Because I'm going to France, we were like pre-recording videos because we want to keep pleasing the algorithm whilst we're away. We don't want to like go cold turkey.
The overlords.
Yeah. So we decided to, a cool video idea would be to set up dating profiles.
Louis bought Tinder Gold on his own.
You pressured me.
No, I didn't.
You pressured me.
I was like, Louis, that's quite
you
a lot
gave
money.
Me money.
No, I was like, you probably shouldn't buy that.
You
and
gave
like,
me
oh,
money.
But I need it, man. You know, pussy.
You were sitting there like, you should just buy it. I reckon you buy it. You, yeah, need, that, you yeah, need to buy it.
It was for the video.
Yeah.
I gave you tenner for it as well, by the way.
It's not it. Like, the whole dating app thing.
Yeah, being single fucking sucks. Like, it's so boring. Like,
oh, no, I was talking about the dating apps.
No, I hate being single.
Oh, okay.
Lad, the constant just sort of like, I know you've never.
It's because you never do. You just sit at home.
No, I don't. I've been out of the house every day.
Doing what?
Trying to hang out with people. And I was like, yeah, no,
you're
busy.
Like,
no, I'm busy.
What are you doing? You're working towards anything? You haven't got like a goal?
Yeah, because right now I don't need a goal.
Of course you do.
No, no, not right now. Right now I need distractions. That's what I need right now.
Yeah, a goal is also a distraction. It's something to focus on. You're not thinking about other things.
Yeah, but I don't have the motivation for that right now.
Thinking about.
Yeah, what am I thinking about? It's too difficult for me at the moment to have that sort of
motivation. That's fair. That's fair. I suppose you do have to have that.
Yeah, I think that's a good message to understand, because we're always like, do this, you know, do the hard work when you're not feeling like it. But there are some days where you do need to not feel like it. So you. I hope you never go through what I've gone through, but I want you to go through what I've gone through just so when you're like, yeah, you know, and I'm like, well, Louis, you know, the grind doesn't stop. Yeah, then we'll see how you feel.
Yeah, and to be fair, I think you're doing pretty, like, you're doing good at the minute. Like, I don't know, I haven't seen you when you're on your own.
Yeah, when I go
but
home,
like,
I
don't think I would be able to socialize right now.
Yeah.
If I was in your position, I don't think I would have been able to socialize.
I think it's because I'm self-aware enough to understand that I need the social interaction.
Yeah.
And so it's like...
That's good though. You're not just like being a hermit, because that's going to make you worse.
Yeah, fuck that. Like,
then you just...
It's mad how, even though I know it's not good, my brain is like, no, you should probably just stay inside. You don't need to do anything today. You should just stay... Like, my brain wants itself to do destructive things. And it's crazy. Like... how it's aware that it will hurt itself, but it's still like, well, yeah, it's just, it's easy, isn't it? You know, no effort. Like, mad.
I'm struggling right, like, with that balance of those thoughts. You know, I struggle with like the opposite side of that, where I always have that thing in my head, like, to do this, like, cause, oh, I know this is like little things. So like
do you mean like intrusive thoughts? Or, well, yeah, what do you mean?
Not like, I wouldn't say they're intrusive thoughts. Like getting stuff done. Like if I do, like, half-ass it anyway, or, like, there's one tiny detail, my brain's like, no, do it.
Oh, yeah, yeah, you're a perfectionist. That's what that is. That's the perfectionist, that whole, the idea. It's like, you know when you're walking down the street, you have been like, if I don't make it to that lamppost before this car does, I'm going to die. It's like... It builds off that, basically. And so you do something wrong, you're like, if I don't fix that, then something really bad is about to happen.
The thing is, I know that it's... Because it's complete... It's, like, fully completing a thing to, like, you know... Cause I know that makes you feel good.
Yeah.
Because it's like a dopamine release of, oh, I've done this.
The satisfaction, yeah.
But it's I think it's getting to the point where it's, like, toxic in the fact that, like, everything's, like... Like it's like, do it. Like, I struggling to let myself relax sometimes.
Maybe you've got, like, actual, like, bad OCD.
Probably. Even like when I'm in bed, like, if I have a lie in, I'm like, my head's like,
well, yeah,
get up.
You are a piece of shit if you have a lie in, to be fair.
Yeah, you are.
You're a bad person, right?
What time do you go to bed and wake up, Yannick?
Well, yesterday I went to bed before 2. And I woke up at like 10. And I was like, all right, yeah, I'm awake now. And I fell asleep until like 12:30. But it was accidental. Like, I was there. I was like, all right, I'm awake now, you know? Fully awake.
And that's dangerous.
Yeah. And I woke up at 12:30.
What about the past few weeks?
Probably go to bed. Like, well, the past few weeks has been all right. The past, like, week or so has been like 4 a.m. I just can't sleep.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm waking up at like 12 and 1, which makes it harder to go to sleep because my body isn't like tired yet.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe I should just start abusing substances.
No.
That seems like the smartest thing to do right
now. No.
I know I brought it up, but speaking of intrusive thoughts, I get mad intrusive thoughts like for little things. Just like throw this. Like walking past someone that's old, just like push them.
Yeah.
Like I get it so bad.
I get that with like juggling things. But like kind of like if you drop it like a glass or like a knife or something.
Oh yeah, it's like throw it, drop it. Just
like doing like that and like flipping it. My brain like if I'm drying it in the dishes, my brain's like, do it. Like do it.
Yeah.
Stop.
Yeah.
And I'll be there like that, like flipping it and just catching it. And then I'm like, tell myself not to do it because if I drop it and, you know, stab myself, mm-hmm. but I just keep doing it and I'll grab it and tense my hand and I'm like, right, there we go. I find like the release is tense in it and like going like
fighting back. Yeah, and then just power.
Going it down. But yeah, no, I get that a lot as well.
I think part of it is being a man. I think men in general get, not even like that, I just mean like,
yeah.
It's one of the things that I don't think women understand is like the satisfaction you get of throwing things off stuff and like, you know, big rocks into the sea or whatever.
Oh, in work, sorry, it's been so satisfying when there's like block, like concrete blocks, whatever, that like half broken or whatnot. So the skips over there,
mm-hmm.
I'm throwing them all the time.
Oh, no, yeah, yeah.
So fun.
I had that with the house cleaners once when we get all like the rubbish and shit and throw it in the skip. Like, you just get big glass tables that you can just throw. It's so much fun. I get that. But I don't think, I think most women wouldn't understand the joy and pleasure that comes from that.
Oh.
It's sad for them.
You know, it's for, you get like the bricks. The actual like normal bricks and they smash way easier and they make like a nice sound. It's like,
yeah.
The concrete blocks I just like throw really far. Practicing my lamp like a lamp. It's like a landmine press. I'm like, mm-hmm. Going back to dating apps.
Yeah, sorry, we're on a bit of a fucking tangent.
I don't like them in the fact that like they're literally just another form of dopamine. Like, yeah. it feels like TikTok on steroids. Mm-hmm. It's a bad.
It's because your brain, like the instinctual primate reproduce.
Women.
It's like, oh, she might like me. She might like me. Hopefully, I'll get a match soon. If you've been there for an hour and a half, only swiping right. You spent 30 quid on Tinder Gold so you can swipe right more. Like, yeah, that's a dangerous thing.
I'm gonna delete it later.
Are you in the hut?
Yeah, I am. I don't like it. Like, I just the whole thing. Like, because I'm used to like swiping up. I'm actually like super like some people sometimes, and I'm like, fuck, I didn't mean to do that. So if I actually super liked you, I didn't mean to do it.
Is that because they didn't super like you back? How many matches have you got so far?
I don't know.
Go on, let's have a look.
I can't see them.
Yeah, you can.
No. Like, no,
I'll show you.
Oh, okay.
I think, anyway.
No, because they disappear after a while.
Oh, have they all matched you?
No, it's just like, I think it's like a 24-hour thing, because it says here, like, new matches only.
Let me see.
Oh, gosh, I'm going to delete this message.
Why?
Hi, babe.
You said hi, babe to someone?
No, someone said hi, babe to me.
What's wrong with that?
Just looks like a weird person.
Because how they talk.
Hang on. Yeah, see here. No.
Why?
Look, see new matches. There's only these. See, that's accidentally super liked. Accidentally, and I was just like, oh
no.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh yeah, that's heavy. How do you get off this?
Let me show you. Press that.
Oh, I didn't. It looks like a download symbol. I don't want to. Is there no way to see?
No.
Wait, have you super liked all of these? Or
no, that's at button 2.
Oh. oh, so these are people that you've swiped right on.
Mm-hmm.
And then you're going to be...
Oh, shit, I didn't think about
yeah.
that.
And this girl's name is Yan. So, damn, you'll be thinking about me, aren't you? She's getting super liked.
Did you... Oh. Yeah, no, I don't like this app.
I reckon you're going to get ready to delete it. And then... you're going to have that last dopamine hit. It's a match. And then all of it's just going to get reset.
Yeah.
That's what it does.
Yeah. It that is like hacking your like brain. Mm-hmm. It's literally like it's... Yeah, it's dangerous.
You're bro. A slave to the game now, Larry.
Yeah. How's your...
My dating app success? Well, Tinder's age restricted me.
Because so. You're only 16.
Because I am only 14 and a half, yeah. So, not great,
yeah.
But, you know, I'm still praying. Sent 18 emails to Tinder support. It's like, let me in, please.
Yeah, the whole idea of a dating app to me is just kind of... And seeing people that I know.
Seeing people that you know on it is weird. Did anything happen with... Not the first one, but the second one. Did you...
I can't see them, can I?
Why?
I just showed you. They disappeared, didn't they?
Oh, shit. Yeah, I don't know the app like, well enough to... So no way... But I thought you matched with them.
Yeah, but it's like...
But it hasn't been 24 hours yet.
I don't know. It just disappeared. I don't know.
Maybe they all matched you.
No, you can't.
You can unmatch people.
Can you?
Yeah. Like, if they're, you know, the person that said, hey, babe, to you, I'll show you how to unmatch someone.
Hang on.
Why? What are you hiding from me?
Hang on.
You've been sending dick pics to girls yet?
Loads.
Girls love unsolicited dick pics.
Yeah, look, see, look, right. You can't unmatch, see?
No, watch. So you can report Lynn.
Oh, hang on. Is it that
or
one?
Or you go up here.
Oh, wait, can you?
No,
you
can. No, surely you can. There's. Unmatch from Lynn.
So look.
There you go. So you press that. Do you want me to do it?
Yeah, press here.
Yeah, that's how you unmatch someone.
Ah, okay. Cool. Yeah, they've all disappeared, though, so. I don't know.
Can I have a look? I'm not going to super like or.
I'm just gonna unmatch.
Everyone?
No.
Oh, just the person.
There you go.
Yeah, so these are people that you've matched with. They're new matches. Yeah, what is all this? Like, and that's just that. Is there... That'll just take you to your profile. Yeah, that's weird.
Mm-hmm.
What is your distance? Is it still like
I think it's
super
on
high?
No, I think it's on 25. But it still comes up with people like that.
Yeah. Yeah, 25 only should have. Mad. I'll put your age range to 90. There you go.
Yeah, it's dangerous, man.
Yeah. Don't get dating apps if you can,
the optimum way. Would be to meet people IRL, but it's difficult these days, and you've got to speak to people,
and then girls are like scared of you if you approach them at night. It's like, what the fuck?
Run at them.
Yeah, apparently girls don't like that.
That's weird, that. Why? I don't understand, that's weird. Why don't you like...
Yeah. What would you say the best way is to meet new people? Like... females.
We're gonna go into the in-depth scientifically proven way. Preferably like doing something you like. Like if you have a similar interest in something, and then just being like, yo.
You'd have to hope that there's a woman that likes the things you like.
Or just like if you're at like a bar or a restaurant or a coffee shop or something.
Yeah.
If you see like someone who looks nice, maybe they're reading or doing something. They've got a nice book.
Yeah, maybe they're meditating and watching a Hamza video.
Just if you see someone you like them, just like, yo, maybe give him a compliment. Say, like, oh, I like your...
Yo, I like your breasts.
Can I view you, please? And then just, like, introduce yourself, I guess.
Yeah. The you get, there's, like, there's the club, but as Ed Sheeran put it, the club isn't the best place to find a lover.
So the bar is where,
yeah,
I go.
Uh-huh. Facts from the go.
Yeah, I don't think the club is... The club's sort of just, like, everyone seems like they're in there to get on someone.
Yeah, to just sort of kiss them and go.
Yeah. Or it's not like, if you're into, if you want, like, a relationship with someone, a club probably isn't the best place to go looking for one, I don't think.
No. And, like, you also don't have to go to a club. Like, you can go to a club single.
Mm-hmm.
Just know that you are, if you're a girl, you're 99% going to get hit on, if not 100%. So just be ready to say no, preferably. But it can be fun to go with your friends as well. Just make sure you're not sober because you're in fight camp, because that is fucking boring.
Would you ever go to a club on your own?
No.
I'd go to, like, a rave or, like, maybe a concert of someone who I really liked on my own.
Yeah.
But not like
the club.
Not like Rosie's in Chester.
No, because I feel like I'd either be the guy that, you know, like the guy with the YOLO t-shirt. I'd either become that, or I'd be one of the guys that sits in the corner, you know, like this, just scouting. And it's like a, it's like, oh, bro.
Shooting, like, his eyes at someone then.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Some guy asked if he could wear my... when we went out after prom, some guy asked if he could wear my suit jacket.
No.
And he was like, no.
Fuck off, lad.
Yeah, I don't know what his deal was. And then... No, fuck, I forgot what I was going to say. Oh, well, couldn't have been important. Ignore me.
Yeah, don't go to the club if you want to find a relationship. I feel like traveling is going to be a pretty good way to find people.
Yeah, 100%.
Especially, like, what I'm doing is, like, there's places I can volunteer, and I can go and, like, live in, like, a volunteering place, like, on farms. If anyone's got, like, even, like, people want help in the house, they should just put that house up. And, like, it's what's called Workaway. And couch surfing as well. Because they're, like, mainly people who are traveling as well. So especially, like, maybe you feel a bit intimidated, you feel a bit lonely. There's no point, like, no one you know who maybe speaks English, and you're traveling in a foreign country. You can put, like, in on a meetup or something. And there's loads of meetups. I feel like that's gonna be really good. And I think you've got to be the one to initiate stuff as well.
Yeah, you can't be socially anxious if you're going
to
travel.
You can't be betting. No, even in general, like, to meet people, you can't be betting on someone coming up to you.
Because
the chances of that happening are very slim.
Yeah.
Much more compared to if you just go up to someone, even just, like, being like, yo, what's your name?
I see, fucking, the amount of times, say, if I've been, because I, before I found Meritor, I went to a couple different, like, jiu-jitsu gyms and stuff, like, trying to meet people, and you're like, oh, like, nice to meet you, I'm Yannick. And they're like, yeah, oh, sweet, nice to meet you, man. And they don't tell you your name. And that's always been something that pisses me off, because I'm then like, oh, like, what's your name? And I feel weird because I've just asked two questions. Of, like, if someone says, I'm whatever, nice to meet you, if you want to carry on talking to them, say your fucking name back, please.
Yeah, maybe they didn't want to talk to you.
But no, because they carried on talking to me.
Oh, right.
That's the thing. Oh. It's just like, it's just a pet peeve of mine that, you know.
An ick.
It's not an ick, but don't do that shit. Imagine if you meet, like, your wife.
Problem.
Yeah. Some, like, French lady that you got to speak to with Google Translate only until one of you learn French properly and she learns English, and then you have 18 babies together. It's like
Jesus Christ.
It's like a Disney film.
Oh my God. I would never want 18 kids.
No, fuck 18 kids.
Hell.
Oh my God.
That, you would, like, walk into that house. If you walked into someone's house who had 18 kids, you would see the look in their eyes of just pain.
Sunken back in eyes, haven't slept in days.
Completely black circles around their eyes. And just the every little child running about screaming, smacking each other, shitting, farting, throwing up. I couldn't deal with 18 of that.
No, one of that's
enough. One is enough.
I think, like, because I don't necessarily want kids, but, like, I think 3 kids would be the max that I'd ever have.
Yeah, I think 3 is a good number.
It's not bad, is it?
It's not too much.
2 boys, 1 girl is what I think I'd want.
Really?
Yeah.
I'd want at least 1 boy.
Yeah, because it's like 3 girls, 2 girls, whatever, like.
I wouldn't be the only man in the house.
Yeah, you need someone to relate to because also there's only so much. You could be the most emotionally intelligent person ever, and there is still only so much as a man that you can pick up on and have actual good advice for and know how to handle when you've got like so many girls, and then you know. Do you think you could have the birds and the bees talk with your kids? I obviously would, but it would be weird for me.
It'd be weird, yeah, but it's just... It'd be difficult to approach. It's one of those things, isn't it? Like, look, man, so...
I've never had it, but apparently... What age would you do it?
Maybe like 10 or 11?
Yeah, I'd say 10 or 11, yeah.
I think that's the perfect age.
Yeah, you don't have to go into like... fat details.
Well, no, to be fair, I think at like 11, especially when they're going to secondary school, that's when I should teach them. That's when you should explicitly talk about sex, not just birds and the bees.
Sorry, I've just, on the back of my phone case, on the stand, it says something you want, a little exclamation mark. I've never seen that before. Huh. Mad. Yeah, like...
Really interrupted there.
Fuck off. sorry. They're going to find out all sorts of shit going into high school, especially if you get to a British high school. You're about to learn everything
there is to know and more.
I don't know if we've talked about this on the podcast. We probably have. But me and Will were talking about it the other day. You know Lana Rhodes' son and how he wasn't even born and he was already being meme.
Mm-hmm.
Like, imagine your whole life being a meme and then...
I feel sorry for him. I feel genuine like remorse for that child.
How I think he'll kill himself before he's 15.
Really?
Yeah.
Jeez.
Or he'll be homeschooled. If he goes to a proper public school,
yeah,
he will kill himself before he's 15.
Yeah.
Or he will have the unbelievable mental toughness.
Can you imagine just walking into school and people just holding up videos of your mum getting railed?
And it's not even just... Yeah, it's not even just video human getting railed. It's like almost like most possibilities that you, like scenarios that you could imagine, there's a video for. It's like, what the fuck?
They're probably going to send it to him as well.
Yeah, airdrop him. Like, he's going to have...
It's a constant reminder. It's just going to be constantly, your mum's a porn star.
10 years of bliss, you know? Primary school, he's not gonna... That'll be fine. And then day one, when people are like, wait, what's your last name? Because obviously her real name isn't Lana Rhodes, so there may be that sort of saving grace for him. But they're
you
gonna
mean incognito, that like hiding your identity.
Pardon?
So say he gets his other surname, his like they don't know his mum's Lana. Like he's gonna be living like... He wouldn't want people to come to his house.
No.
Because if they see his mum...
Oh my God, yeah, fucking hell. Could you imagine being like... Imagine being the first person that made that connection. That would be like...
Going over there every day.
Oh, yeah.
No, so what are you doing today? Can I come round?
Yeah.
Is your mum in?
Oh, I just...
You'd have to live like... Like, you know when people who are like... threatened by gangs and whatnot, they like
witness protection.
Yeah, they relocate and get new identities and everything. Like, you'd have to do that. You'd have to like go off grid or something, or move to a different country, change your name, cut all ties.
Yeah. I think the possibilities are kill himself before he's 18. If they somehow don't find out, like in Infinity War, when Doctor Strange has 14 billion possible things, he's like, there's the one. There's that one chance that everything goes right for him.
I don't think that's the timeline, though.
I
have you seen the video? It's like her on a podcast with him, and he's lying there like...
Yeah.
You can see like the pain in his eyes.
Already.
And the couch is just like, this guy already hates his life. He knows what's coming.
He might go to prison. I reckon
he'll resent people.
He'd probably commit a crime when he's older, I think. Probably. It's just like... There's also, what happens when he wants to start watching porn?
Not Lana Rhodes.
Yeah. Oh, God. Imagine...
The homepage.
Right. Her real name obviously isn't Lana Rhodes, and I assume he's going to know her real name.
Mm-hmm.
So what if he doesn't make the connection until it's like too late? And I mean that by the sense of like, you know, some year seven is there like, oh, you know, I've just found out what porn. Like, you know, look at this person I like. And or they'll just say a name. So, you know, he'll go home and be like, Google how to beef off, and then go on porn or whatever, search up Lana Rhodes, and then just 1,000+ videos of it. There's no good, yeah, you're right, there's no good timeline for him. That is one poor bastard.
Makes you feel grateful.
But yeah, you know how we were talking before about
give thanks, praise the Lord that I am not that child.
Like, before we were talking about, you know, my situation and how my situation is pretty shit. I know people that have got it worse, and I'm not them.
Give gratitude.
And so that's what's keeping me through this. Is it can always get fucking worse. Remember that. Be grateful.
Yeah, gratitude.
Yeah, understand that sometimes you do get shit. No, yeah, you do get dealt shit cards. Mm-hmm. And you're allowed to not always be happy. Mm-hmm. But try to safely remember that it could be worse.
You can either... Oh, for fuck's sake.
Nice.
You can either remorse and hate everyone, or you can sort of try and look on the bright side. As difficult as that is.
There's always take what a you've silver got for granted. Lining. Yeah.
I mean, he's going to be rich at least.
True.
But, like, would you rather be rich and you want to be a porn star, or be poor and...
have a normal family?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well...
yeah, rip to that kid.
Thanks for watching our last ever episode.
Cheers, guys.
Season 2, August. Coming soon.
Maybe.
If Louis
comes back.
I might just stay out there. Or I might get kidnapped or die. Who knows? Mm-hmm. Go with the flow. Yeah, man.
Peace.
West Side. Keep it real. Au revoir.
Auf Wiedersehen.